Now we know a lot about correlation between two numerical variables, but there are more than just numerical variables. Thankfully, there's a way to determine whether there's a relationship between categorical variables. For this purpose, we'll use chi-square. So we'll use chi-square. This is not an x, this is chi-squared. And basically what it does is, if our cases can be classified into several groups, it determines if the sample is representative of the general population. So, for example, you have the record of a Vietnam War platoon, and you're interested whether there's a relationship between dying in a fight and education. If there is no relationship at all, the education of the casualties should be representative for the entire group. Again, the first thing you do is draw a table. So you draw a table, this could be number of observation, so soldier number 1, number 2, 3, all the way down to 40, because a platoon contains around about 40 soldiers. Then you have the status, so killed in action or okay for alive, and you have the education. Okay, now observation number 1, he is okay and he might have a high school diploma. Number 2, he might be okay as well and he has a bachelor's degree. Number 3 might be killed in action and he is a dropout. And you do that all the way down to observation number 40. Okay, now later we'll summarize our data by the factors. And we have our first factor, education. So, education. And you have the levels of your factor, and it comes with the levels master for a master's degree, so an officer, for example, bachelor for a bachelor's degree, high school for a high school diploma, and you have dropout for soldiers. So this is a D, a dropout for soldiers without a high school diploma. So this is our first factor. Then we have our second factor, that would be status. And it comes with the levels killed in action and okay for alive. Okay, let's summarize our data. How many soldiers do have hold a master's degree and were killed in action? 0. How many soldiers have a master's degree and are okay? Let's say 2. And the same goes for bachelor, let's say 1 and 4. High school, let's say 5 and 16. And dropouts, let's say 10 and 2. So this is our summary. What we want to know is whether the status of our soldiers is independent of their education. Now, just by looking at this, do you have an idea whether it is independent or not? Well, to me it seems that it's much more likely to get killed if your education is low. By the way, this data is completely made up. This could be due to several factors, but it seems that dropouts, for example, are extremely overrepresented in the killed in action group. So you have 10 soldiers that don't have a high school degree and were killed in action, and only 2 of them are okay. So they overrepresented in the killed in action group. For this, we have a statistical test called the chi-square test. So the chi-square test is a test for independence. And if you put in the data into R, and we'll do that in the next video, it would give you a chi-squared value of 13.84, and more importantly, a p-value of 0.003. The chi-squared value by itself won't tell you a lot, because it depends on the size of your table, and therefore we take a look at the p-value. So the chi-square value itself doesn't contain a lot of information because it contains on the size of our table, and therefore we always take a look at the p-value. Now, the null hypothesis states that there is no zero relationship between those factors. In other words, the null hypothesis states that the status is independent of the education. Again, we'll use our significance threshold of 0.05, and the value of 0.003 is highly significant, and we have enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis of independence. So we can accept the alternative hypothesis of dependence and between status and education. And now we only know that there is a relationship. But how strong is this relationship? There are several measures for this, but they all suffer from some defects, and there is no perfect measure of association. So in my opinion, Cramer's V does a good job. It gives you a value between 0 and 1. A value between 0 and 1, while 1 equals perfect association and 0 equals no association. The defect it comes with is that it tends to inflate the value for big tables. So, for example, if you have a lot of levels in your factors, for example, it tends to inflate the value for Cramer's V. So check out the next episode when we do this in R and I'll actually give you a value for Cramer's V.